There are several approaches you can take for specifying your floor finish in your plans. In this video, we're going to look at specifying floor finishes for the entire plan, for individual floor levels, individual rooms, and other tools for specifying the floor material in specific areas of a room. The fastest way to change your floor finish is to be in a 3D view and pick a new material from the library browser. To do this, open up your library browser, and then navigate to the desired folder where you can find materials and then pick a new material that you would like to use. With my material selected, notice how my mouse changes to a spray icon when I bring it into the plan, indicating I'm about to change a material. In the bottom left-hand corner, there's different spray modes. If you wanted to change the floor finish for a single room, you can switch to component mode and then click in the room to change the material. If you wanted to change the floor finish for all rooms on a floor level that share the same flooring material, you can switch to floor mode and click to change the flooring material wherever it's located at on the floor. And just like with being in floor mode, if you wanted to change the material everywhere it's located at in the plan, you can switch to plan mode and exchange it on a plan-wide basis. This method of choosing new materials directly from the library browser is the fastest way to pick a new flooring material and is an excellent approach if your goal is to quickly evaluate floor finish options. Let's close the library browser, press spacebar, press undo a couple of times, and take a look at some other ways to change flooring materials. You can pick out a floor finish to use in the plan by specifying one through your default settings. You can access this by going to Edit, Default Settings, and then going down to Floors and Rooms and clicking on Floor Ceiling Platform. Here you'll see an option that says Floor with two more options for Floor Finish and Floor Structure, with the Floor Finish resting on top of the Floor Structure. Under the Floor Platform settings, if you click on the Edit button next to the Floor Finish, here you can see the layers that are making up the Floor Finish, the materials being used, and the thickness of those materials. On the right hand side, you can insert new layers into your floor finish, move layers up and down, delete layers, and see your total floor finish thickness. Let's change our floor finish material from being a blonde wood material by double clicking on it and then picking out a new material from the library browser and clicking on OK, and then OK a few times through the floor finish. Specifying the floor finish through the floor ceiling platform settings lets you specify what the floor finish should be for the entire plan, but you can have different floor levels use different floor finish materials. Let's take a look at how to do this by clicking on Done, and then next let's build a new floor by going to Build, Floor, Build New Floor, and then next Chief is going to ask, how do you want to build the second floor? Do you want to build the second floor based on the first floor plan, or do you want a blank new canvas to draw out the second floor? We're going to select the top option, which will build the second floor exterior walls below the first floor exterior walls. And then next we can specify the second floor defaults. And if we want to change the flooring material for the second floor, we can go down to Floor Finish, click on Edit, and then change our flooring material from our floor platform defaults to something else. For the purpose of this example, let's change the flooring material to be a carpet material. Click on OK and accept our floor to defaults. And there you can see Chief has built the second floor and it's using that carpet material. Let's open up the default settings and take a look at a few interesting things here by going to Edit and then Default Settings and then going down to Floors and Rooms. And you'll notice here that we have this option for floor levels, and if we expand it, we have an option for the first floor and the second floor. If we take a look at the second floor, and we come over to the floor finish option, you'll notice here that there's a checkbox that says default. When this setting is checked, the default second floor finish will just follow the default material chosen under the floor platform settings. When this is unchecked, like it is here, the default floor finish for the second floor will not follow the floor platform settings, but instead follow the floor finish you've picked specifically for the second floor. And same thing for the first floor. If the default checkbox next to floor finish is checked, it'll follow the floor platform settings, but if it's unchecked, it will be using a different flooring material. So to review what we've covered up to this point, under the floor platform settings, you can choose the default floor finish that should be used for the entire plan, but under the floor level settings, you can stray away from this setting and choose the flooring material on an individual floor level basis. Next, let's talk about choosing a floor material on a per room basis. If we double click on room types, you can see I have a variety of available room types, and here you can choose the default floor finish that should be used when specifying individual room types. For the purpose of this example, if we click on the bath room type and click on edit, and then if we go over to the structure panel and then go down to floor finish and click on edit, you can see that the bath room type is using an ivory tile material. Let's draw out a small room in our plan, define it to be a bath, and see how Chief adjusts our materials by canceling out of our default settings, and then going to our wall tools, selecting the straight interior wall, and then draw out a small room in our 3D view, and then press spacebar, select in the room, in the bottom left-hand corner, select the Open Object Specification button, and then under Room Type, if we change it to be a bath, and then click on OK, in the 3D view, you can see how it adjusted the flooring material. And again, if you wanted to change the flooring material of this room, there's several ways you can do that. One is through the library browser. The second way is you can double-click in the room, go to the structure panel, and then under floor finish, edit the floor finish being used. And then the third way, which we haven't talked about yet, is with this room specification open, you can go to the materials panel, select on floor finish, and then click select material and choose a different material from the library. Next, you may have scenarios where you want varying floor finishes in a small area of the room. You can accomplish this by using the floor material region tool. Let's go back down to the first floor, and to use this tool, go up to Build, Floor, Floor Material Region, and then just click and drag in the room where you would like to apply the floor material region. If you wanted to be very specific with the floor material region's position relative to other objects, you can get into your floor plan view and then use the dimensioning tools to dimension it from other objects. If we double click on the floor material region, it'll open up its specification, and you have an option here that says material layers, and if you click on edit, just like with defining our floor finish, we can click on the material layer and change it to be a different material. You can also change the material by opening up the library browser, picking a new material, and then applying it to the material region.